Okay, so in this video, I want to talk about NotebookLM. And I think in many ways, this is sort of one of Google's very early prototypes of how to do RAG and trying to build a product around the whole retrieval augmented generation ideas. So I want us to think about like how it's going to work. And then also, we'll have a look at where Google is sort of planning to take this, because I kind of think that's also really interesting. Now, I'll say from the outset, I don't think this is ever going to be a big Google product. In fact, I will not be surprised at some point if they discontinue this product. This product actually says that it's an experiment in the name or next to the name here, as you can see here. One of the key things I think is that NotebookLM is really the attempt to see, okay, what do people want in RAG? What works? What doesn't work? And then my guess is that eventually a lot of this will just be folded into other Google products over time. I think it's worth having a look at this before perhaps it goes away, and also just to sort of get some ideas for perhaps how we could make our own version of something like this. So NotebookLM is not new. It's sort of prototyped at Google I/O 2023, and where it was called Project Tailwind. So that was sort of like the middle of last year. And at that stage, I think it was still, you know, quite an early sort of idea of what they were sort of looking at doing. And they weren't even sure exactly how they were going to do it, etc. Around the end of last year, they actually launched it more and they added a lot of new features in there. They started to actually promote it externally and stuff in there. One of the key people behind this is a guy by the name of Stephen Johnson, who was actually an external sort of person that was brought into Google to help with this project. And he himself is an author, has written quite a number of books over the years, that kind of thing. So it's sort of interesting to see as they've built this project around, you know, some of the ideas that people would want for being able to create things with text. So they've got these blog posts all about it. What I feel is rather than just go through some of the things in here, why don't we actually jump in and get started and load some of those up? So here is the NotebookLM interface that we've got here. It's a very simple kind of interface. You've got this sort of canvas where you can put notes and stuff like that. You've got a bottom area where you can basically ask questions. We've got a side panel where we can upload various files. So you'll see that if I click here, I can upload PDFs, text files, and I can paste copied text as well in here. All right, so what I'm doing now is it's just uploading three PDFs, which were actually those articles that I showed you before, where I've just printed them out as PDFs. So at this point now, we can ask some questions. If we come in here and type at the moment, we won't be able to type anything. We actually have to engage some sources first. So you can see here now I've selected three sources. I can come in here and type. Okay, so I can ask it, tell me about what NotebookLM is. And you can see it goes straight into a sort of standard chat interface. And now it's basically using those PDFs as a sort of grounding source for being able to generate the answer here. So the idea is that this shouldn't be relying just on the core LLM. It's basically doing sort of a RAG over this. So it gives us quite a decent response back about what NotebookLM is. And we can see that, okay, how does NotebookLM work? It talks about the sort of idea of grounding. What are the key features in here? Automatic summarization, question answering, idea generation. And you can see at this point, we can now also pin this so it becomes a saved note in here. This is kind of a nice feature, right, for RAG. So now I can basically ask it some more things. So it's generated some questions. I can basically take those questions. And you can see I get a response out now about grounding. I can save that. So now you can see that I've got a few of these notes that I've generated from this, from just asking questions and stuff. Now I can actually take this and I can use it to do something. So I could create an outline. I could combine them to a note or something like that. I can ask it to do something like generate me a blog post. Okay, so I've asked it to generate a blog post. I can save that back in there as well. You see, now very quickly, I've got a bunch of these and I can ask it to make a study guide and it will just automatically make a new note that is a study guide in here. So I'm able to go from my source material to something that I could repurpose, that I could, you know, do a bunch of different things with. So this is the general gist of where this is. Now, where this is going is interesting too. So let's take a look at what they showed is coming in the near future with this.
Last year at I/O, we introduced NotebookLM, a research and writing tool grounded in the information you give it. Since then, we've seen a lot of momentum with students and teachers using it. And today, Gemini 1.5 Pro is coming to NotebookLM, and it's great. Let me show you. So here we are in NotebookLM. You can load it up with all the materials here on the left. In this notebook, I've been using it with my younger son, and I've added some of his science worksheets, a few slide decks from his teacher, and even an open source textbook full of charts and diagrams. With 1.5 Pro, it instantly creates this notebook guide with a helpful summary and can generate a study guide, an FAQ, or even quizzes. But for my son, Jimmy, he really learns best when he can listen to something. So we've prototyped a new feature with Gemini, and it's called Audio Overviews. NotebookLM is going to take all the materials on the left as input and output them into a lively science discussion personalized for him. Let's take a listen.
So let's dive into physics. What's on deck for today?
Well, we're starting with the basics, force and motion.
Okay.
And that, of course, means we have to talk about Sir Isaac Newton and his three laws of motion.
Ah, yes, the foundation for understanding how objects move and interact.
Ah, yes, this is where multimodal really shines. Now, it generated this audio discussion based on that text material. And what's amazing is that my son and I can join into the conversation and steer it whichever direction we want. When I tap, join.
Hold on, we have a question. What's up, Josh?
Yeah, can you give my son Jimmy a basketball example?
Hey, Jimmy, that's a fantastic idea. Basketball is actually a great way to visualize force and motion. Let's break it down.
Okay, so first, imagine a basketball just sitting there on the court. It's not moving, right? That's because all the forces acting on it are balanced. The downward pull of gravity.
Pretty cool, right?
Okay, so as you saw in the video there, there are two sort of big things that are coming to this. First off, and probably the sort of bigger thing, apart from the voice, is the actual fact that they're going to move to a Gemini 1.5 Pro model. So currently the version that I'm using here and showing here doesn't use the Gemini 1.5 Pro. And you could imagine that this version is actually having to do some sort of vector search lookup of the docs to do things. So it's going to be a bit slow at doing some of the searches. There's going to be a certain latency in there. Having the new 1.5 Pro model is going to probably allow you to take, because I think you can only put like up to 20 PDFs in here. I think that's going to allow you to basically take all of it and stuff it into the context. So this is already sort of a new way of doing this kind of RAG sort of idea going on here. And I think it's interesting to see that this is probably how Google is going to do a lot of these things for things like workspaces, for that kind of thing. Obviously, the other really impressive thing that they did in there was add in voices. So it's probably not that hard for us to prompt this to make a podcast out of doing something like this. As you can see here from just the current version, I can just basically ask it to generate a conversation between two people talking about the benefits of NotebookLM. We get person A, person B, and we've got a conversation there. So we could pass that off to someone else. Now you can see another point I forgot to mention in here is that you can actually see the citations, right? Where it's pointing to things in the source material. So the PDFs have actually been all converted to raw text in here. And now we're able to go in and look at different citations for where things are actually referring to in here. Again, this is like a key feature that a lot of people are not putting into the rags that they're making. And this whole idea of citations, I perhaps talk about this with another product that I'll make a video about. But this is one of the key things that creates trust in what you're doing versus what you're not doing in here. So let me keep that as our podcast. Let's just say that's our podcast. You can see, sure enough, it's up there. So on top of the new model, the idea of being able to getting voices interacting with this so that they're creating a podcast based on this. Now you can see that that wasn't that hard to do to get it started. And with a couple of voices, we could get this going. But you can also see that here, then it becomes a lot more interactive if you allow it to be a conversational experience. So one of the key sort of points about this video is I'm trying to get people to think about how do you make RAG systems and chat systems that go beyond just the simple chat interface? You can see here we've got a whole sort of note-taking interface. We've got multiple ways for engaging with it. The new version obviously is going to add voice to that as well, you know, going forward. And I feel this is the thing that people need to be thinking about if you're looking to do this, because I feel that the whole chat with PDF phase that we had last year really was a whole sort of wrapper phase, and those things are on the way out for sure. But we will see vertical specific versions of these. And a lot of that's going to come down to deciding what's the best thing for your particular vertical as you're doing this. So I feel that NotebookLM, while it's probably perhaps doomed as a product unto itself that may not be around forever, it is a good, interesting experiment of and showing some of what Google is experimenting with and trying out for seeing how these kind of RAG systems could actually work in various different verticals and seeing what do users respond to, what do they like, what sort of features do they want, that kind of thing. So have a play with this. If you're in the United States, you can use it straight away. Currently, if you're in a different country, I guess the number one thing I could say is a VPN is your friend for this. So the URL is notebooklm.google.com. Make sure you've got a VPN if you're outside the States. They are going to make it available internationally, I think, in the not too distant future, perhaps when they add the voices and stuff like that. Maybe then that version will be made accessible to more people. But anyway, have a look at it, have a play around, and then start to think of how you're creating your own sort of RAG apps and how you could actually be taking some ideas from this and from other things to actually make them much more interesting and much more interactive than just purely chat alone. I feel the days of just chat alone are sort of on the way out. ChatGPT has definitely done an awesome job at expanding that, and it's really good for a general sort of audience or a general product. But for people who are designing things for verticals now, really need to think much more about how they can make this go beyond purely just chat. I'll probably do a few of these videos looking at different products that are out there that have got interesting ideas that I feel that for us as sort of professional AI builders should be sort of studying to see, okay, what are people doing and how can we do that for a particular project that we're working on, etc. Anyway, as always, I'd love to hear what your thoughts are. Please put them in the comments below if you've got questions or anything as well. If you found the video useful, please click like and subscribe. I will talk to you in the next video. Bye for now.